Hey, EPC family, I'm with my Pass and my Big Dog. Those are my nicknames for them. Feel free to use them while you're here. I don't mind. Pass.
Hey, hey, Magnificent
Big Dog. Okay, so 2020, they're coming back. What can our observers and commissioners expect this year at General Assembly?
Well, I could tell you, but a picture is worth more than 1,000 words. Watch this.
Okay.
Next year, in the city of blues, barbecue, and Bill, where grizzlies still roar and a king still reigns, where flight meets commerce and children meet healing, in the city where one dreamer was silenced 50 years ago.
Because I've been to the mountaintop.
Tens of thousands now have a voice. In this city, the city of Memphis, our assembly will gather.
What a historic and cool city. In 2020, the EPC will be 40 years old if the Lord delays his return. And as you know, the numerology of 40 is high typology in the Bible. So whenever we see 40 in the Bible, think of three things. One, self-examination. Two, self-denial. And three, special preparation for victory, for a new venture, or a renewed venture.
I think it's important to focus on that latter principle of special preparation for victory, for a new venture or a renewed venture. You see, a victory follows each of these 40-day biblical references. This was true for Noah and the great flood when it rained 40 days and nights, preparing to repopulate the earth. For Moses, spending 40 days and 40 nights receiving the law and the Ten Commandments. For Jesus, fasting in the wilderness 40 days and nights, being tested by the devil before his victory. And the apostles spending 40 days and 40 nights with Jesus after the resurrection, preparing to receive the Holy Spirit and begin the church age.
So likewise, 40 years is a grand time for the EPC to examine the challenges and victories of the past, as well as explore the challenges and victories of our present future.
So Megan, what does all this mean for our next generation of EPC leaders?
Yeah, so you have some leaders who are really familiar with what goes on at the General Assembly, and some who may not understand the value of what takes place during this week. So pastors, I strongly encourage you to invite a next-gen leader to come with you, either to observe or learn, or to be a commissioner. Find ways to collaborate together. And just don't underestimate the power of reaching out and letting someone know that you would like them to come with you. Millennial leaders, I hope to connect with you while you're here in Memphis. Hope will be very intentional on working with the EPC and other millennial leaders to plan things with your interests in mind.
Again, we're really excited about having you in Memphis. I'm trying to convince Jeff, our stated clerk, to take the whole assembly to Beale Street one night for ribs and blues and fun. And just in case some of us get into a scrape on Beale Street, defending infant baptism or standing up for John Knox. Did you know that Jerry, our assistant stated clerk, was 6 years an assistant district attorney?
I did not know that.
Get out of jail free card. What a denomination. See you in June of 2020.
Yes.